All right, guys. Well, welcome to the travel, our planning 2021 edition. Thanks to the New Lenox Library for having me come and speak to you guys about travel planning and how COVID has affected that and moving forward, what your options are as far as traveling and travel planning options go. So thank you to the New Lenox Library for letting me come and speak to you guys. I grew up in New Lenox and I grew up growing to the New Lenox Library. So this is so fun. When I get to do stuff with the library, it seems very full circle. So this really, really happy to be here. But for everyone who's watching this, I like to have a presentation outline for at the beginning of all of my talks, just because I know everyone's time is important. And it's just really nice when you know just the topics that I'm going to be talking about. And so we're going to talk about the importance of travel. We're going to talk about why you should use a travel agent. And then we're going to talk about places that are open for travel post 2021. And now obviously that last point is always being updated and it changes every day. So by the time anyone is watching this presentation after, if you're watching it recorded, then this information is going to already be out of date, but that's okay. It's awesome that stuff is opening every day for travel. But before we get into that, a little bit about me. I have been traveling since 1994. I've been my first vacation when I was 9 days old. I obviously don't remember that trip. My parents probably would rather forget that trip, but that definitely set us up for just a lifetime of traveling. That's always been a motto in our family, is that we value experiences over things. And I've always wanted travel to be part of my life. And when the opportunity came to open an agency, we just jumped on board. I was in grad school getting my master's degree and just wanted to go and climb that corporate ladder. But then this came along and this sounded so much more fun and was something that I could call my own and create a business that was mine. And so, yeah, we've done that. We opened it in August of 2016. And these past 5 years have been an awesome growing experience. Obviously, the last 2 years have been very different than the first couple years, just with COVID and the pandemic changing everyone's lives. But it's been very fun. And actually, last year, we were voted Travel Agent Central's class of 2020, their 30 under 30 list. So we have had fun and we've been recognized for it. And that's awesome. But our philosophy as a family and as a business is that travel is an investment. It is an investment in time. These trips take time to plan. They obviously take time when you travel. It's an investment in your money. Good trips are not always expensive, but they always cost something. And so it is going to be some money to go travel. But it's an investment in your life. And you're going to be a better person when you travel, and it's most definitely worth it. So that's our philosophy. That's how we have, that's just how we live our life. And so hopefully that comes through on the trips that I plan, comes through in your travel agent's plans when they give them to you, and that you're working with an agent, you're working with someone who loves to travel and wants to share that love with you. Now, throughout this presentation, I am going to have quotes scattered through because people that travel more than me are usually more eloquent on how they talk about travel. So I have this quote: an investment in travel is an investment in yourself. And Matthew Karsten said that. He's a digital nomad, a travel photographer. Basically, his job is to go around the world, take pictures, explore these great places, and he gets paid for that. So I thought I had a cool job until I learned about digital nomads and travel photographers. And I realized that that would be the literal dream. So maybe catch me one day being a digital nomad, but I liked when he said an investment in travel is an investment in yourself. It's very important to travel. I think even more so now after the pandemic and as we enter life post COVID-19, that to get back into the world and to experience these new cultures and these new places that we've either been to before but want to see again, or these places that we've never been to, it's just so important and a way to better yourself. You better the people around you when you come back and you tell them their stories of your travels. It's really just an awesome thing to do. But that's why I think travel is important. I know we kind of rushed through that, but it's so important just to make sure that you are investing in yourself with travel. But we are going to now talk about why we should use a travel agent. And this is going to be the main portion of the presentation. And I've broken it down into these five kind of main categories. Obviously, there's more. When you use your travel agent, I'm sure they're going to have their points that they want to tell you about, you know, why you should use an agent instead of booking direct. So ask them too, but these are my main five. One, better pricing. We're going to talk about that right away, get kind of the elephant in the room out of the way and, you know, talk about either your travel agent's going to be have the same pricing that you're going to have online, or even better pricing with more inclusion. So we'll talk about that. We'll talk about the importance of having a professional planned itinerary and how that can offer you just that much more convenience as part of your travel. Talk about how a destination expert can help you on your trip with little insights and tips, the concierge service that you're going to receive when you use a travel agent. And then after 2020, we all know that everyone needs an advocate for them when stuff goes wrong and a global pandemic happens, and you're going to need an advocate for you for all of those rescheduling or those cancellations that you have to do. So we'll dive into that and then we'll get to where's open now to travel. But let's start with better pricing and exclusive perks. Travel agents, one of the main ways that they can offer better pricing is through group rates. And when I say group rates, this means that either a travel agent or a group of travel agents has taken out space on cruise ships or with hotels or tour companies. You know, theme parks, all these places, they take out that group space sometimes years in advance. So, you know, right now I'm planning my 2024 travels and I'm taking out group space up to 3 years in advance. When that happens, that means I lock in, you know, 2021 pricing, which is going to be a lot better than 2024. It means I get the space that I want. Those rooms that book up quickly, they book up quickly because travel agents get them because they know that they're going to be able to sell them to their clients. They're just thinking ahead, they're looking out for you. That means that they will always have the best pricing because they'll either be able to book into that group rate, or if a special sale comes along, they'll be able to book you into that space and that sale instead. And, you know, we can kind of compare which offer would be better. And you're the one that ends up winning with that. They have additional perks that they can offer. We'll talk more about that on some of the subsequent slides here. And they also have special inclusions. Sometimes, you know, if you book with a travel agent, it might be the same price that you would pay online, but you get a little bit more included in that price. And so you might as well get what you pay for, right? One thing I would note is there's kind of two types of travel agents out there. There are travel agents that charge a booking fee or a planning fee to use their services, which is just an upfront fee that you pay. That's going to be an additional cost to the trip that you plan or the price that you pay for your travel. And then there's no fee agencies, which are probably a good 85 to 90% of travel agencies out there. The majority of them are going to be no fee agencies. And that means that the price that they give you is the price for your travel and that our rate is just included in that. You don't pay that rate. It means that the companies that we're going to send you to, whether that's Disney or Royal Caribbean or Riu Resorts down in the Caribbean or AM Resorts, places like that, places that you're going to travel with anyway, already have in their budget to pay for a travel agent. And if you book with direct, they pocket that money. If you book with a travel agent, they obviously pay your agent that money. So you're paying for a travel agent anyway, you might as well get what you pay for. But let's look at how travel agents can maybe have either the same price with more exclusions or better pricing. We'll look at Disney, an example first. This is pricing that I got, I believe it was last Friday. So it's a little dated, but not much. If you were to go online right now and look for a week in Disney in February, this was at the Disney's Coronado Springs Resort for 7 nights and a 4-day theme park tickets for 2 adults, round trip airport transportation, and of course, I always include the memory maker for my clients just because, you know, you want those pictures at the end of the trip. That's going to cost you $3,365 if you go to Disney right now and book that. Now, if you go to your travel agent, you can book that same package. So you see the same 7-night stay at Disney World Resort. That's Coronado Springs again. 4-day theme park passes for 2 adults. Round trip airport transportation and memory all included too. Same price, but with a travel agent, you also get a free round of mini golf. And believe me when I say this, there's not many things that are free at Disney. So take advantage of it when you can. Discounts at select stores and restaurants. You get free entry into Wide World of Sports. There's sports complex there on property at Walt Disney World, and the concierge service of a travel agent. We'll talk more about concierge service when I get later in the slide, but that means, hey, you're standing at Small World in Magic Kingdom's Fantasyland, and you say, man, I really want a Dole Whip. What's the best way to get there? Now you can look on the app and it can show you where you can find those, or it can show you the best way to get there, but the app doesn't always take into account parade times or crowd flow or just certain things like that. If you book with a travel agent, you're going to be able to text your agent and say, hey, I would like to do this. And they're going to say, okay, no problem. Let me show you how to get there. It's quick. It's easy. It's as easy as texting. There's no special apps or anything like that. You get that in your pocket. So while everyone else is trying to find where to go on an app, you're already there and you're enjoying your Dole Whip without too much hassle. That's just one example. Obviously, take that example and go into anywhere in the world. We're going to be able to help you out with that. So that's obviously just more inclusions for the same price. Let's take a look at this. This is Royal Caribbean. This is with a 5-night cruise in February. If you book it right now, on their website, you're going to pay $1,560.50 for 2 adults for an ocean view balcony cabin. It's actually a really good price, even though we're going to see the travel agent can save you a little bit more money. So that's what you get. You get all of your taxes and port fees in that, but you're still going to have to pay gratuities. You're still going to, have to pay for all your drink packages and whatnot. And that's really just your cruise. If you book with a travel agent, just with a group rate that I have access to look at. So every travel agency is going to be a little bit different group rate, but this was just for an example. You are going to pay about $350 less for the same room. So you're getting the same thing that you would have been paying for anyway for less money, but also there's more inclusion. So your gratuities are included for a 5-night cruise on Royal Caribbean. That's $7,250 per person it's not really required, but it's strongly recommended. People pay in gratuities for their trip. So that's an extra, we'll say $150 there that you're saving, even though it doesn't necessarily see it on paper. You also get the opportunity to earn up to $125 onboard credit, depending upon the type of room that you book and how far out you book the room. That credit can be used for shore excursions or drink packages or specialty dining on board. It's really just free money for you to use as cash on board your ship or on board your trip. And then you have in-room treats every night. These are just something that travel agents can do. We can make cupcakes show up in your room magically, or we can have some chocolate covered strawberries delivered on a special night in your room. We like to add those little special touches to you, and that's all included in your price already. That's just something we can throw in. And then a pre-travel gift. Royal Caribbean sends me a lot of stuff to pass on to my clients. And believe me when I say this, I do not hoard it, but I have a ton of it. So I'm definitely going to pass that on to you, and you can take advantage of that pre-travel gift. So it really is not going to cost you any more money. And in fact, it's going to save you some money usually, or it's going to get you more for the money that you're spending if you use a travel agent. So my advice to you would be, if you're on the fence of using a travel agent, maybe you're just not really convinced that it's not going to cost more money, or you're just wanting to plan it yourself and not wanting to necessarily give up that control of your vacation, what I would say is to try it once. This is my quote for this time. It's just a Chinese proverb, so I don't have any specific person to attribute this quote to, but it's, don't listen to what they say, go see. Let's just try it out once with a travel agent and see how much easier it is, see how much money you save, and see how much more value you get for your time and your money when you use a travel agent. I think you will be very, very pleased with how the situation turns out. The slide is also a chance for me to show off some of my favorite travel pictures. In the top left corner, I'm in Innsbruck, Austria, one of my favorite places in the world, above the cloud line, which is just such a cool thing to see. The bottom left, I am in Mexico at one of the Mayan ruins with my brother-in-law, having some fun jumping off of them. And then the bottom right, I am in on the Amalfi Coast in Italy, which is also one of my favorite places in the world. I have a lot of favorite places in the world. So if you want to go see these places, talk to your travel agent. They would love to send you there, especially now that things are starting to open up. So that's price. We got the big one out of the way. It's not going to cost you anything more. But let's talk about these other value-added services that a travel agent can provide you. You're going to get a professionally planned itinerary, which means it's detailed. They take the guesswork out of travel. We can plan it for you. So when you sit down with your agent, most of them are going to have either a phone call or an in-person meeting to start your trip planning process. We're going to get to know you, and you're going to be able to convey your wants and your needs for your travel, for your vacation that you want to happen on this trip. So we're going to take note of that, and we're going to make sure that those are all planned and included in your itinerary. So your itinerary is going to be personalized. There's not, even if it's a packaged vacation, your travel agent is going to make sure that the package meets your needs and that it's personalized for you. In that meeting, you know, if you mention you like food, your travel agent is most likely going to either include a cooking class or a tasting for something. You know, if you like dolphins or marine animals, we're going to make sure that you can swim with the dolphins or go meet the whale sharks or cool experiences like that. I actually was just researching a trip for a potential client that wants to go to Kenya, and one of their bucket list items is a hot air balloon safari, which, to be honest, I didn't even know existed when I first started this trip planning process. But now it's definitely on my bucket list for sure. You wake up in the morning super early, go up on a hot air balloon, and you're able to see the animals that way and that unique way. And not only is it cool because you're in a hot air balloon, but you're also in Africa and seeing these animals that you only see in zoos here. It's an amazing bucket list trip. And they mentioned it. And of course, I'm going to include it in my trip and my personalized itinerary for them, because that's something that they want. And we're going to make sure that that happens for them on this trip. And when you get a professionally planned itinerary, it's going to be complete. So all of the hard work's already taken care of. There's no looking for confirmation numbers. There's no trying to figure out how you're going to get from point A to point B. All of that hard work is done for you. That way you don't have to worry about it. You can just go and enjoy your trip. When you use a travel agent, you're also going to be able to work with an expert. We are product and destination specialists. We're not just Google. Now, don't get me wrong, do your own research for sure. But anyone can read reviews, but only travel agents have the access to product or destination training or specialist programs. Supplier training means, you know, Disney or Royal Caribbean, we've talked about a lot, you know, Secrets or Dreams Resorts or Globus or Trafalgar Tour Companies. They offer their own training for travel agents, which means that we get trained just the same way as people in their call centers do when you call them direct. So we're trained just like that to work with you and find the best deals, book you for that. But you also get that personalized service of booking with the agent that you always have worked with and that is going to know you. So we are trained by suppliers, we're trained by destinations, tourism boards, whether they're for different towns, like Orlando has a tourism board, or different states. We have different countries have tourism boards, like for that Kenya trip, I've taken they're called Magical Kenya Tourism. I'm now a trained Kenyan travel destination specialist. I get to pass on that knowledge that I've learned with my clients that I'm looking for it now, but now I have that knowledge for when people come to me again and want to go to Kenya. And your agent is going to take time to do that supplier and that destination training, because that's our job and we love to do it. You don't have time to do that. Believe me, you want to get your trip planned and you want to just go and you want to be able to enjoy your travel. Let us do the hard work for you. Let your agent do the hard work for you. And you just get to share in that, the reward for that when you work with a destination expert. Another favorite quotes from Susan Sontag is, I haven't been everywhere, but it's on my list. It's a pretty, pretty common quote. I understand that. But when you think about that, if you're like me and you want to travel everywhere, there's no really way that you can be a destination expert for all of these places if you have to do all the research yourself. You have your job, you have your own responsibilities to look for. Use a travel agent, use their expertise, and that way you don't have to be the one that that has to take the time to do that. We've kind of talked about this throughout the presentation so far, but let's really dive into it right here. When you use a travel agent, you're going to have concierge service, which means start to finish, you're with one agent. So we've already talked about that initial consultation on the phone or in person. It was always in person, and now since COVID, it's kind of always been on the phone, but now we are hopefully, since we're opening up, can kind of do whatever works best for you, but your agent is going to get to know you. And from that initial start through your trip, through your travels to the follow-up call, you're going to be working with one agent. With some of these bigger companies, it might be an associate of that agent, but it's still one company that's going to know your trip, that's going to know your needs, and is going to be able to better serve you. You're not going to have to explain yourself or introduce yourself to a different person each time you call in. They're going to know you and they're going to want this trip to work amazing. You're going to have 24/7 customer support, which means you have a direct communication. My phone is actually right here because I have people traveling. I know that I'm giving this speech, but I still am on call. So you have direct communication with me. There's no 1-800 numbers. It's always, you know, if something happens, you get to call me. Now, let me tell you, I do everything I can for that not to happen. I hope that you don't even think about your travel agent when you're traveling. But if something does happen, you get to call your agent. And they get to be the one that say, I'm so sorry that happened. Don't worry about it. I'm taking care of it. You go relax and keep enjoying your trip to the best of your ability. We've seen that really come to fruition with COVID. Now, emergencies do happen. Travel agents are there for you. I love the saying, when the ships hit the sand. Now, I had a marketing professor, this is very much a sidebar, that always said that, and it stuck with me. And now I get to use it in a way that really actually, that makes sense. He was from Annapolis, so he was really big at, you know, go Navy, be Army, all of that fun stuff. So he always said that. So we're here for you when the ships hit the sand. Now, obviously, we've never experienced a global pandemic before last year, but emergencies do happen and emergencies will continue to happen. I've said it before, we do everything that we can, your agent will do this for you, to make sure that that doesn't happen. But the inevitable still happens. And so we're there for you. And we can be an advocate for you, whether that's just saying, hey, don't worry about it, I'll take care of this. Or if you're, you know, needing to manage your different hoops that you have to jump through now that COVID is a thing, and maybe the entry requirements back to the States changed while you were gone, or maybe, you know, just different travel documents were required right before your trip. Your agent's there for you. Their ears to the ground. They're looking out for that information, and they're there for you and to get that information to you. So you have to worry the least amount possible when you're traveling or before you're traveling. The entry requirements for COVID, Clarice and I were talking about before we went on, they're just always changing, and there's these different hoops you have to jump through, and sometimes they change hour by hour. And so your agent is going to be there for you to help you manage those and do the best of their ability to make sure that it's as seamless a process as possible. I'm also going to be there if you need to cancel or rebook. Not that there's ever a good time for a global pandemic to hit, But when it hit last March, it was right at the height of spring break travel. So we had all of these people either right before their trips or on their trips that we now had to either cancel. We had to rebook them into earlier flights to get them home before everything shut down. It was a complete mess. We had hold times up to 8, 9, 10 hours. Some people couldn't even get through to the companies that they booked these trips with. When you have a travel agent, you get through to me. I will say at that point, it was definitely, I might've had to call you back just because I had a lot of calls coming in, but you get in or you call in, you have your piece of, you know, man, I have to cancel my trip or I have to rebook. Your agent says, you know what? I completely understand. Don't worry about this. I have it. So now they get to be the ones that wait on hold for you. And, you know, back in the early days of the pandemic, companies were not that willing to give refunds or to help with clients, you know, rebooking, and they were charging a lot of fees. But with the travel agent community, we were able to lean on these companies a little bit and say, hey, I'm not going to book with you again if you don't help my clients out now. You know, we have buying power. It's a lot easier for me to say that and for them to listen if I have, let's say, 50 people that are going to travel with them throughout the year, as opposed to maybe your family of two or four that are just trying to rebook a one trip. We have clout. We have some buying power, and we get to be the ones that have to be the bad guy to the company. You don't have to fight with them. You get to work with your agent instead. And so that, to me, has shown itself to be, I think, the best reason to use a travel agent. Yeah, you're going to save money. You're going to have the benefit of that professionally planned itinerary. You're going to have the destination expert with you in your pocket all the time with that concierge service. But at the end of the day, you're really just going to have an advocate for you should something happen and you need to rebook. And again, it's all included in the price that you're already paying for. So you might as well get the most value for your dollar. Here's another. I thought we had another quote. Sorry, apparently I don't know my own slideshow. But let's move on to where you can travel now. There are destinations opening every day, and it changes kind of sometimes hour by hour, but the world is opening up again, which is such a great thing to see. And hopefully this presentation has whet your appetite just a little bit for travel if you haven't already been there. And if not, hopefully we'll get you traveling somewhere soon. But right now, the open destinations, we have domestic favorites. So that would be Disney. Disney is open and they're mask free even right now. Now they're mask optional, I should say that. So if you still feel more comfortable wearing a mask, you're not gonna be, you know, looked down upon at all or anything like that. But if you do not wanna wear a mask, then you don't have to at Disney. Hawaii's open also, a couple more hoops to jump through. You have to have a negative COVID test 72 hours beforehand. You have to have a profile on their public health website. But they're open and you can go, and they are really missing our tourism dollars. So they really are wanting people to come. So that's so cool to see it open. Our national parks have always been open. I think they do not get the credit that they deserve on how cool of a destination these places are. You know, the Grand Canyon, Yosemite, all of these places, Yellowstone, are just in our backyard, easy access. And they're some of the most beautiful destinations in this world. So they've always been open. They're still open. They want you to be there. They want you to come. Mexico and the Caribbean are open too. As of right now, as of today, as I'm saying this right now, there's no entry requirements for COVID. I mean, you still need your passport. You still need all of those documents, but no additional entry requirements because of COVID. Now, again, that could change tomorrow. So always make sure to check with your agent for the most up-to-date entry requirements. As of right now, no entry requirements for COVID in Mexico. Some of the Caribbean islands do require you, much like Hawaii, to get a COVID test right before you go, like 72 hours beforehand. Easy to do though, as you know, it's I know I have to get them for work sometimes, but you it's easy to go get a COVID test these days. It's nice. So you can travel for sure. You also have to have a negative test to come back into the States from these places. But again, because the travel agent in our community kind of leaned on these resorts, they're now included in most of your stays. As long as you stay 3 nights or longer at these places, we didn't have to have people going to find places to have tests done. We wanted it just to be kind of included in your all-inclusive resort, even the, not just food and drinks, we wanted your COVID test to be included there too. So it is now, most resorts will covering that through the end of the year. And as the, maybe the mandate goes on, they'll continue to cover that. But right now they are uncovered for your resort. So you don't have to leave. You can just take your test right there at the resort. Your results get delivered to your room. Trying to make this as seamless as possible because the tourism industry is just dying to come back, and they want that to happen. And destinations around the world are opening up throughout the world and every day. So I know Greece and Croatia and Spain are open right now. I know Italy is opening kind of a slow process there, and the rest of the EU, like I said, hour by hour they change, and they're just so ready to welcome people back. So call your agent to book sooner rather than later. Don't let your destination fill up without you. We're going to have a real big supply demand problem when things do open all the way up. So if you have some place that you want to book, make sure you're calling your agent as soon as possible, because we want you to be able to travel to where you want to travel and not have to wait even longer than you have been throughout this whole process. But before I leave it, for any questions that might've come in, or just leave you with a quote from one of my favorite travelers, Anthony Bourdain. I love this quote because I think it sums up a lot of stuff. Travel isn't always pretty, and it isn't always comfortable. Sometimes it hurts. It even breaks your heart, but that's okay. The journey changes you. It should change you. It leaves marks on your memory, on your consciousness, on your heart, and on your body. You take something with you, and hopefully you leave something good behind. I hope you all are ready to get changed by travel again. Hope you all are ready to get into the world again soon. I hope that I have sort of, if not made you completely ready to go, made you think about starting to think about what travel places you want to go, what destinations you want to go. And of course, I hope that I have explained to you just the real benefits of using a travel agent to help plan your trip post-COVID, and really just before COVID too. You should have been using your travel agent, get what you pay for sure. But if that is all that I have right now, if there are any questions, Clarice, let me know. But other than that, thanks everyone for listening.